Mr. Young's a carpenter. He's doing some spare time work at Meg's unit. Extra cupboards, drawers, that sort of thing.
I see. Well, I think you might have let me know, Mrs. Powell. This is not personal, Mr. Young, but for obvious reasons, we don't encourage social relations between the officers and the families of inmates.
This is hardly social, Mrs. Davidson. Meg made the arrangement some time ago, before Janice Young was here. We only found out about the relationship last night, didn't we, Mr. Young?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, right.
Well, it certainly is a remarkable coincidence.
Shower away, lad. Wind's biling. Queen of the night, second. Very tight for third. Copper Canyon or range, lad.
Feel like a cuppa?
Oh, yes, please, ma'am.
I must say, I'm so glad to see you looking so happy.
Well, things are going pretty good, aren't they? There's a lot of casual jobs in the paper. I'm sure I'll be able to get one tomorrow without too many hassles.
I've dealt with the likes of you for years. So, it's over. Either we're partners, or you've just made yourself the worst enemy you'll ever have. All right, Mackenzie, what's it to be? I haven't got all day.
What's going on?
It's all right, Maxie. I'll catch up with you later in the rec room. And keep your trap shut. I haven't got much of a choice, have I? But I do have some conditions.
You're in no position to call the shots, Mackenzie.
You're the one who wants to buy in on this deal. You'll make a lot more if we can bring in stuff the women can't get from the buy-up.
Like drugs, you mean?
Not necessarily.
Forget it. I won't let dope in.
All right, then. Grog, a few extra fags, makeup, stuff like that.
How do you expect to get that in?
Maxie has a friend called Roxanne. She'll bring them in. All you've got to do is arrange the visit and turn a blind eye.
Huh? I can arrange that for 50%.
30.
50.
I've still got to pay Roxanne and Maxie too.
So, pay them out of your profits. Just look on me as an expensive overhead.
All right. You got a deal.
Where are you off to?
I'm going out.
Well, you should be phoning round for a job. There's no point in going to the labour exchange at this time of day. All the best jobs will be gone.
Yeah, well, I got an interview, see?
What interview?
About a job. It was in the paper and I phoned up and they said to come for an interview. I phoned up while you were at the shop.
Well, what sort of job is it?
Oh, just a factory job. Down at the bedding factory in Pine Street.
Well, it seems a funny time of day to be going for an interview. Be closing down soon.
Well, I had lots of people to see. Well, I might better be going or I might miss out.
All right, but don't be late home for your tea.
Yes, Mum.
So, how are the kids?
No, they're okay. They're mad keen for you to come home.
Well, so am I. I wish you could bring them in.
I can't, love. You know that. They think you're staying in the country.
I just want to see them, that's all.
Well, why don't you get yourself out of here, eh? Look, I'll talk to the solicitor.
No, Chris, I told you I'm not going to pay a cent.
All right, all right. Don't get on your high horse. It's not long to go anyway.
I'm sorry, love. I know it's hard for you, but...
Yeah. Yeah, well, look, I've got a quote on a job.
Okay, don't forget to water the plants.
Plants be the last of my worries. As long as the kids are clean and fed, reckon I'm coping quite well. Oh, did I tell you I got some new business cards printed?
No.
Have a look. Oh, sorry.
Yes, they're great. They're much better than the last one, aren't they?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I'll be seeing you, kiddo.
No physical contact,
oh.
Mr. Young.
Sorry. Bye now.
Bye.
Wait here. Mrs. Barfield will come and get you.
Hi. Can I come in?
Of course you can. Hey, you want a cup of coffee or something?
No, thanks, dude. I'm on my way to the hospital, actually, to see the baby. I thought you might like to come.
I'd love to, but I can't take the time today. I let this paperwork get really behind and it's caught up with me. But you give him a big hug from his grandma, huh?
No, I will. Dude, I really appreciate all the help you've been giving us lately.
Hey, come on. Don't mention it. I just wish I could have given you a bed.
Oh, that's no problem. Aunt Sarah's been on my back for years to stay with her.
Hey, you gonna see Laurie tonight?
I don't know. I just can't get through to her, dude.
Why don't you give her a little time? I think that's the only thing that's gonna help. I can remember when I had Laurie. For a week I was depressed and then everything seemed to go well for a month or so, then...
Yeah, I know. Laurie told me all about it.
Well, that's what I'm trying to say. It might not be all plain sailing. She could come out of this, sure, and then maybe in a week or a month she...
Yeah, yeah. Well, I suppose I better go and see how the little fella's getting on.
Okay. Hey, come back and have dinner with us.
Oh, yeah, okay. I'll see you later.
I know it's hard to run a house and work at the same time, but Chris can handle it. Well, he's got to.
Yeah, it'd do him good to realise there's more to housekeeping than just watching the midday movie and slapping a meal on the table.
Feel bad about the kids, though. Just hope we did the right thing saying I was staying with relatives.
Oh, sure you did. Look, you're only in here for a few weeks, and once you get out, well, they'll be none the wiser.
Sounds to me like you're having second thoughts about paying up.
No. There's no way that lying swine's going to get a cent out of me. He caused the accident. He can pay for it.
Good on you, mate. Excuse me. What's a freak doing in there?
She's on to us. I've had to let her in as a partner.
Oh, terrific. Well, you can count me out. I'm not having nothing to do with that bitch.
It's not as bad as all that.
Oh, yeah? Well, by the time she's taken her cut, it'd be sweet if I left for us.
We can get the stuff in from outside. She can arrange visits, turn a blind eye.
Yeah, well, if Bea finds out we're dealing with Ferguson, we're history.
I'm not worrying about Bea. And if you're scared, then forget it. I'll find someone else who wants the money.
All right. But I tell you, if anyone finds out the freak's in it, we're gone.
Then let's make sure no one finds out.
And what was that all about?
Hey? Oh, nothing, B. Nolan and me just got to work out a plan to get a few extras in.
Like what?
Come on, ladies, shop's open. Anything you like, I can get it in for you.
Decent air conditioner. The stuff in here is revolting.
Got any money?
Yep.
Okay, hold it. Just a minute. What do you think you're up to, Nola?
Like I said, I've moved into the import business.
And how are you getting the stuff in?
Oh, me mate Roxanne's bringing it in, B. I give her the order and she gets the stuff.
Right under the screws' noses. Or maybe you've got yourself a friendly screw.
Oh, of course not, B. Me and Roxanne have worked out a plan.
Tell me about it.
Trade secret, B. You're not the only one that can fool the screws, you know.
Come on, ladies, let's have your orders before the screws come round. Anything you like.
Anything except dope.
Didn't I mention that? Oh, sorry, girls. Anything you like except dope.
You must be mad if you think you can get away with this.
I don't know, B. It's worth a try. And we'll make a few bob out of it.
I'm glad you came. It's amazing what doctors can do for kids these days, isn't it? Take that little one over there. The sister was telling me about him yesterday. 10 weeks premature he was. Had about a 50-50 chance. He's just under observation now because of some lung trouble he had. You wouldn't know it now, though. In fact, to look at them all, you wouldn't think there was a thing wrong with any of them, would you? I guess it was right what I read in some article the other day, that the thing that makes a disability into a handicap is other people's attitudes to it.
$45, $46, $47. That's at least 17 for us. Not bad for our first order, eh?
Yeah, but that's an awful lot of stuff. How am I going to get it back here from the interview room?
Have you ever done any shoplifting?
Are you kidding? Me and Roxanne were the best in the town when we were kids.
Well, how about sewing a few pockets on the inside of your jacket?
Not a bad idea. I'll go to the laundry later and get a few rags and sew them on.
Well, what's this? The Wentworth Chamber of Commerce. Oh, you ought to be careful, Mackenzie, leaving all that money lying around.
Not all the officers pussyfoot around like you do.
Is that all?
Oh, give us a chance. These things need to build up. Maxie, you'll have to make a phone call tomorrow.
See me and I'll arrange it.
Oh, well, I'd rather it didn't look like a setup, Miss Ferguson.
I bet you do. But you know me, Daniels, the height of discretion. Just make sure you don't let anything slip.
Rotten bludger.
Ah, oh, forget her. She's a necessary evil. Here, this should cover Roxanne to buy up and her cut too.
More than enough, if you ask me.
What do you mean?
Well, she'll probably nick half of it.
Oh, will she?
Here, you take that, I'll give her this. She'll do it for me.
If the freak doesn't know about this, we can beef up our profit margin a bit too. But you'll have to be careful what you say to Roxanne, though.
Don't worry. Me and Roxanne understand each other real well.
Pot, thanks, love.
G'day, Murray.
Hey, well, I'll be damned. When'd you get out, love?
Oh, only yesterday. Thought I'd find you around here.
You know me, always drink at the same water and I'll creature a habit.
No, it's my shout. Take it out of there. I had a good win this arvo.
Oh, what on?
Share away, lad.
What did it start at?
4-1 on the tote.
We've gone round and seen Bill. He'd have given you better odds than that.
He's still running the SV ready.
Oh, yeah, it'll take World War III to put him out of business. I'll give you his number.
Ah, tough.
Cheers, love.
Cheers.
Well, what are you going to do with yourself now you're out?
Get yourself a decent job, I suppose. Not going to be that easy.
Snow's always looking for people.
No, thanks. Don't want to end up inside again just yet.
Good on you, love. Steer well clear, I reckon. Tell you what, a mate of mine just started up a cleaning business. Offices and that sort of thing, you know. He's always got jobs going. That's if you don't mind getting up at the crack of dawn.
Doesn't worry me. What I've been doing inside all along anyhow.
Beauty. We'll go around and see him after. He'll fix you up. He owes me a favour.
You're a good mate, Murray.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Evening. Mrs. Powell.
We had children tonight.
Oh, no. I managed to get a babysitter at last. Across the earth. At least they're not under my feet all the time. Or under yours.
Haven't you got any relatives who could help you out?
Oh, no. My family's all in Adelaide. Janice's are all up in Sydney. I've got one aunt. She's stuck out at Castlemaine. That's where the kids think Janice is.
Oh, I see.
Still, I'm not doing too badly. I'm turning out to be quite a fair cook, you know that? Kids were getting fed up with having beans on toast every night. You on your own tonight?
Meg's late shift, yeah.
Oh, yeah, right.
Well, I won't keep you.
Yeah, I'd better get stuck into it, I suppose. Can't afford to leave the kids too long with a sitter anyway.
Daniels, Kennedy, Mackenzie, Smith, Stokes and Young, off to the laundry. Come on, move out.
Please, Miss Ferguson, I'd like to make a phone call.
Oh, really, Daniels? Perhaps we could run an extension into your cell for you.
Hey? Well, I'm allowed one phone call a week and I haven't had one for ages.
Don't tell me the rules, Daniels. Now get to work.
Oh, but if I don't call now, my friend will have gone out for the day.
I said get to work, Daniels, unless you want to find yourself in front of the governor on a charge.
But all I want is one rotten phone call.
Hey, Maxine, go for the charge. I'd be very interested to see what she tries to make it.
You keep out of it, Smith. Now get to the laundry. Right. Come on. Now get on with it and be quick.
Phone call?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're entitled to one a week. They usually start whinging if they don't get it, so it's easier to give it to them. Have you had your break yet?
Yes, I'm just leaving here until the receptionist arrives. Uh-huh. She phoned to say she'd been late.
Roxy, it's me, Maxine.
Have you had a look through the papers yet to see if there's anything needs censoring?
No.
Well, we'd better have a look then, haven't we?
Yeah. Now, look, it's all arranged. There's a screw that's going to make sure you get in okay. A Miss Ferguson. Roxy, I tell you, it's safe as houses. Right. Now, you got a pen? Listen. 2 bottles of medicated shampoo. 1 bottle of Eastern Silk conditioner. 3 pairs of pantyhose. Now, listen, 1 large and 2 medium.
Yeah. Now, got see, it? This article here about the attempted escape from Barnhurst, yeah, I don't want to talk that should come out because it'll only give our women ideas, you see. Right? That's the sort of thing you've got to look for.
Right, see.
And any articles here about women who've been charged with offences against children, take out their names just in case they finish up in here. Now, come on, Daniels, don't take all day.
Yeah, righto. Now, 3 miniatures of scotch. Got it? Good. Now, Roxy, I'll give you the money when you come in, OK?
Yeah,
oh, yeah. I was wondering if you could get the stuff at that shop we used to go to. Yeah, that's right. I reckon it could be real cheap if you go there, if you catch me drift. Roxy, you're a real pal. See ya.
Any trouble?
Nah, she's sweet. No worries. Hey, thanks for helping with the freak.
Did you get on to your mate?
Yeah. You know, I reckon the freak's losing her touch. She just gave me the phone and left me to it. Reckon she was more interested in showing the new screw how to cut up the newspapers.
So it's all arranged?
Yep.
Well, just whisper to me, Maxine. How do you expect to get the stuff in?
Well, I told you. Me and Roxy have worked out a way. But if I told you and it gets around, well, they'll all be doing it.
Okay, we'll leave it at that for now. If I ever find out that you were in cahoots with a screw...
I wouldn't do a thing like that, B.
Well, I think your friend Laura would. You better make sure you don't.
Morning, Mum.
The kettle's boiled if you want a cup of tea. You can get your own breakfast.
Yeah, okay. Thanks. I'm sorry I didn't make it home for tea last night.
I thought you said you weren't going to be late.
Yeah, well, I didn't mean to be, but I ran into an old girlfriend and we went back to her place for a while.
For a while? It was past 11 by the time you got back. You could have phoned.
Yeah, sorry.
What about your job interview?
Oh, I got it. I start at 4 o'clock tomorrow morning.
4 o'clock in the morning?
Yeah, it's a cleaning job, see, cleaning offices and that. You have to start real early, but it pays real terrific.
For cleaning work? Oh, I don't think so. Still, a job's a job. They're jolly hard to come by these days.
Yeah.
What are you planning to do today?
Oh, thought I might look up a few old friends.
Oh, I thought you might have wanted to make some new ones now.
Come off it, Mum. I'm old enough to run my own life.
Well, just make sure you don't get home too late if you've got to get up early in the morning.
Yeah, all right, Mum.
Hello. It's you. Was that any way to greet your mother? Sorry. I thought it might be Jeff.
Well, he wanted to come, honey, but I thought maybe you'd need a bit more time on your own to sort things out. Laurie, I don't mean to interfere. I know that postnatal depression is a really bad trip, but one of these days you're going to get over it, and you're going to really feel badly about giving up David.
Don't you think I realize that now? I know exactly what I'm doing, Mum. Just like you did when you gave me away.
That's not fair.
Fair? What's fair? You decided that you couldn't cope with me when I was born, so you adopted me out. I can't cope with a handicapped child, so I'm going to do the same thing. What's the difference?
Laurie, When I had you, I had no job. I was in a strange country. Everybody looking down their noses at me because I lived with another woman. I knew that the only way I could give you a fair chance was to give you up. You think that was easy on me? Always wondering how you were, always thinking about how you looked and how you grew up. But that's my story. You have got a good husband, a great future. You can offer David everything. That's what the difference is.
I can't. I just can't handle it.
Can't? Can't or won't? Murray, what's wrong with you? What are you afraid of?
Jeff and I just wanted a baby. A normal, healthy baby.
Okay, so you've got one that needs a little bit more love and care. Is that any reason to just throw him away?
Oh, just leave me alone, Mum, will you?
Laurie, now just think for a minute. Think of all the heartache that you went through when you found out you were adopted and went to look for me. How do you think little David's going to feel in 20 years' time? And what are you going to say to him when he does find you?
I'll just have to make damn sure he never does, won't I?
You should have never had a baby. You're not fit to be a mother.
No, I'm dead set worried that Bea's twigged.
She can't prove anything. Stop worrying about it.
Oh, I can't stop worrying. You know what she's like once you get on the wrong side of her?
Yeah, I got a scar to prove it. She won't be so lucky next time, though.
I'm supposed to see Barbara Martin today.
Yeah, well, you have to wait till after the exercise period.
Oh. Well, can I have a word with Bea?
Oh, why not? You seem to have the run of the place lately, anyhow.
G'day, Jude.
Hey, you look like you lost your best friend.
Try daughter.
Laurie, what happened?
It's a long story, honey. It's not a very nice one. The baby was born deaf.
Oh, hell.
I know. And Laurie's completely rejected him. Jeff and I have gone blue in the face trying to talk around. Doctor says it's postnatal depression. Well, whatever it is, it's really screwing her up.
Oh, Jude, I am sorry.
I know. I can't just let him raise the baby on his own. I'm going to have to go to Queensland when I can and help out. What am I going to do about the house and everything else?
Is there anything I can do to help?
I'm short of waving a magic wand to get her to change her mind. I don't think so. I mean, I've tried to talk to her. I can't get through to her.
Is it completely deaf?
Looks that way.
You know, it's amazing the things they can do these days. I remember when I was working on the Braille machine, I learned a lot about the blind. They can practically live normal lives. It makes you look at them very differently. And remember Georgie Baxter? Well, she was born partly deaf, but they managed to cure her.
I know all that, but you try and tell Laurie that. She thinks he's some kind of freak or something.
Well, there just might be a way to make her change her mind.
Well, all right. I'm willing to listen to any suggestion.
Hello?
Is that you, Jeff?
Oh, Judy, I was hoping you'd ring. How did it go with Laurie?
Well, no good, I'm afraid.
I would have rung you earlier, but I had to go around to Wentworth.
I'm glad I did, too, because one of the women there came up with an idea that might just bring Laurie around.
Well, I'm clutching at straws now.
Yeah, well, it just might work, too. Look, can you get around here about 5 o'clock? I've got to make a few more phone calls, and I'll tell you all about it then.
I'll be there.
Great, bye.
Bye.
Hi. Did you see the new shelves?
Yes, just what was needed. He's certainly an excellent carpenter.
Well, he'd have to be good at his trade to be doing so well. Although I don't think he's handling the housekeeping side too well.
Well, he could always get a housekeeper in. I mean, if he's genuinely in need, the PRG or even Parents Without Partners would probably help.
Well, he's not the type to accept charity, but a housekeeper, that's a pretty good idea. Might see what I can organise.
Well, why you? I mean, that's a social worker's job.
Staff room.
Mrs. Powell, could you come to my office, please?
Yes, of course, Mrs. Davidson. See you.
We're getting away.
Come on, Alicia.
Where is it? He hasn't even mentioned it.
Mansion Downs on the outside moved up quickly, grabbed the lead, and Mansion Downs drawing away will score by a little over length of the finish. Alanisa flashed up the
third round. Done a few bob, have you?
That was me last 5 bucks.
Your mask? George, you were throwing it around like a woman with no arms yesterday.
Easy come, easy go. Yeah, that is.
You're worse than your old man.
Then mine? My show.
No, I'm right, thanks. No, I've got to get going.
Listen, if you're short, I could put you in the way of a few bucks.
No, thanks. I don't fancy going round the local pawn shops with a handful of hot radios.
Cameras this week.
What if? Thanks to me good mate Maury here, I've got a legit job. I'm going to try going straight for a while, right, Maury?
You're right, love. Here, cop this. Till you get paid. And don't go putting it on any three-legged horse.
You're one of the best, Maury. See ya.
Here, love. Look after yourself.
Come in. I was wondering how long it's been since there was a check on the armory.
No, I'm sorry, I'm not sure.
Well, I'm sorry to give you such short notice, but I would like a stock take and a check on the condition of the firearms as soon as possible.
All right, fine. Is there any reason for this?
Well, nothing specific. I've just been talking to Mr. Douglas, and it looks as though there could be another security check.
Oh, that's a worry.
Well, I don't want to give the department any more cause for criticism. The armory is supposed to be properly maintained, and I would like to make sure it is.
And when are they going to descend on us?
All I know is Mr. Douglas wants a meeting with me in the morning. Apparently, there have been some rumblings from the minister about the running of the prison.
Oh, and he'd know, wouldn't he? He's been in the business ever since the last election.
I wouldn't let Mr. Douglas hear you say that.
Who is it?
It's me, honey, and Jeff.
Just go away, both of you.
Please, Laurie, we just want to talk to you.
Where are you off to, Laurie?
Anywhere. I really don't care.
Honey, why don't you put it off for a couple of days?
On earth for, Mum?
Well, there's something we want you to see tomorrow.
Oh, yeah? What is it?
Well, I'd prefer for you to wait, huh?
You two are just wasting your time. Nothing you can say or do is going to make me change my mind. Jeff, I'm not coming back.
What are you going to do?
Anything. I don't know. Just go away and start a new life somewhere, away from you, David.
Laurie, you're not going anywhere, not until you give me one more chance.
Maybe she needs a bit more
time. No, Judy, I've been leaving her long enough to sort herself out. It's about time she realised that she doesn't have to face all this on her own. I'm her husband, I love her. And she shouldn't be too bloody proud to lean on me or anyone else who wants to help her. Laurie, I've never hit a woman in my life. But if I have to do that to keep you here, then I will.
All right, Jeffrey. Damn you, but it won't make any difference.
Well, we'll pick you up in the morning, love.
Take the car keys, Jude. I'll stay here tonight and make sure she doesn't change her mind.
Bye, honey.
In Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on Sweet Mar... Oh, sorry, love.
Always like to have a bit of a sing in the mornings. Makes it not quite so lonely. Keep forgetting you're working here.
That's all right. Doesn't bother me.
Hey, do you know what's on telly this arvo? A Cary Grant film.
Yeah?
Yeah. Never miss him. One of my favourites he is.
I never watch movies myself much.
Well, what do you do in the afternoon, Sam?
Listen to the races, mostly.
Yeah, well, now there's a coincidence. Because my nephew's a jockey, no one well known, country race meetings mainly. But he was saying last night he was on a real good thing tomorrow at Oakdene. What was the name of it? Aztec something or other.
Aztec Dynasty.
Oh, don't fancy his chances.
Well, Barry knows what he's talking about. Reckons I should have a couple of bucks on it myself.
Oh, I'd save you money if I was you. See, Aztec Dynasty's a mud runner. The wetter the track, the faster he goes. Oakden's about as dry as the Nullarbor at the moment. You won't see him for the dust the other horses kick up.
Oh, please yourself. Well, I'm not a punter. Just thought you'd be interested, that's all.
Damn it. Hurry up and finish your breakfast, you two. You'll be late.
Don't like it.
Oh, what a shame. There's nothing else unless you want black toast.
Dad, don't forget soccer training tonight.
Oh, hell. Well, can't you get a lift with one of your mates? I promised Mrs. Morris I'd go over there and stain her shelves tonight.
Mum normally takes us all.
Does she? Oh. Well, all right, mate. I'll see if I can get her on the phone. Put her off.
Meg Morris speaking.
Oh, good day, Meg. It's Chris Young here. Look, I'm afraid I'll have to cancel out on that arrangement we had tonight. Something's come up with the kids.
Well, nothing serious, is it?
Oh, no. It's just something I totally forgot about. I'll have to work out something with you later, all right?
Fine.
Good. I've got to rush now. Thanks. Bye.
Who was that? That was Chris Young. He can't come over tonight. Something's come up with the kids. Babysitters or something like that.
Oh.
G'day, Faye. You're keen, aren't you? Don't very often see you in here this early.
Well, finished work a couple of hours ago. Feels like it ought to be tea time.
Well, you won't find many of the regulars in till later on.
Yeah, I couldn't face staying home all day.
Fair enough. Are you drinking?
It's a bit early for the hard stuff. Get some orange juice.
Yeah, right. Fancy the radio on?
Yeah, why not?
The Prime Minister may cut short his overseas trip because of the crisis. Two people were killed and three injured.
How much?
My shout. You're in so early, I haven't even got a float in the till.
We enough. Cheers.
10 kilometres from Wodonga. Police have not yet released the names of the casualties. Vandals broke into the Oakden racetrack last night and caused some havoc by turning on the sprinkler system. The grounds have not been watered for some time due to severe water rationing in the area. And the track, which should have been fast, will now be very soft going for the meeting scheduled for this afternoon.
Aztec Dynasty, you little kitty!
The next news service will be at 11 o'clock. Now, back to music.
What are we doing here?
You'll see.
I'm not going in.
Oh, come on, love. I did a lot to organise this. Now you promised.
Come on, Laurie. Get out of the car.
Take me back to the motel.
Laurie, you're coming with us, even if I have to carry you.
Hear some sounds, especially the low frequency sounds such as ah and or. The children must also get used to hearing sound from infancy, and that's why they're fitted with hearing aids from the age of 3 months. How old's your child, Mrs. Maynard?
He's just a baby, 6 weeks.
Well, it'd be hard to establish the extent of his deafness until he's about 12 months or so. And then when he's 3 and a half, he'll come to a kindergarten just like this.
Jason,
and he'll be taught signing
and
lip reading.
Jane, on your seesaw, please.
Well, what happens then?
I suppose he spends the rest of the time in an institution.
Oh, no, of course not. We're here to give the children communication and language. Some of these children go on to ordinary schools. Although it's impossible to say just what will happen to your child until we know the extent of his disability. But even after 6 months' training, these children are perfectly capable of communication. Look.
Well, maybe Belinda wants to go down to the
Sue, give me the red pencil. Good. Now, run over to the door and shut it. Good girl. All right, next one. Ready for the next one?
It's wonderful. Do the children live here?
Only Monday to Friday. They go home on weekends. It's an advantage if the parents can continue the training over those 2 days.
Is it very hard to learn?
Oh, no, no. Look, you pick it up in no time.
What's the matter with you?
Oh, g'day, Roxy. You got through the gate all right, then?
Sure. Just flashed a bit of boob at the gal. Sent me to reception to get searched.
All right, hurry it up.
Good girl. Hey, no probs?
Nah. Went to our usual place, like you said. Gave us a real good price.
Good one. Hey, how the fellas doing?
Oh, not bad. Well, Scales got nicked for speeding.
Oh, not again. Did he do his licence?
What licence?
Oh, God, I didn't think it'd take up this much room.
Hey.
Right, is that the lot?
Yeah.
You got the dough? Yeah. Now, cover it.
Yeah, sure. Anything for a mate.
Do you think it's had any effect at all? She hasn't said a word since we left the school.
I'm not sure. I mean, look at her. She looks so lost.
What's wrong, Laurie? What are you afraid of? I love you, Laurie. I know it isn't going to be easy, but together we can give David all the love he's going to need to come out on top of this.
Talk to the doctor. It's a beaut kid you've got there. And a beaut husband, too.
Yeah, I know. You're not too bad, though, either.
Oh, come on. What'd you think I was going to do, turn my back on you?
Well, I wouldn't have blamed you. I said some really horrible things to you, Mum.
Honey, everyone goes through a rough patch occasionally. I mean, hell, look at what I was like. The trick is to know when to take a helping hand.
I love you, Mum.
And I love you.
Hey, mister. It's your mummy. Want a cuddle from your mummy? Hey? Of course you do. There you are.
It's okay.
Well, Grandma, I think we're a family again.
I thought you'd be in the pound by now.
How'd it go, Maxie?
Piece of cake. Hey, you lot, you can all collect your stuff after work at Nola's cell. Oh, that's
good. Yeah, and how did you get the stuff past the freak? And don't tell me she just didn't take any notice.
Yeah, well, I got lucky, didn't I, B? The freak didn't supervise the visit. It was Officer Barry. You know what she's like. You drive a semi past her and she wouldn't notice.
Like you said, you did get lucky.
Ooh, I can just taste that scotch right now.
Yeah, well, don't go breathing it all over the screws.
What's the matter with you, B?
With me? Oh, nothing. Nothing at all. You wouldn't begrudge an old girl a drop of drink, would you?
No, Lizzie, I wouldn't. But what does get right up my nose is Mackenzie comes in here, offers you all a few lollies, and you follow her around like the Pied Piper. And no one remembers who Patty Lawson was anymore.
Of course we do, Bea, but we're stuck with Nola, so we might as well use her up while the going's good.
And line her pockets at the same time.
Oh, you're just grumpy, that's all.
Hey, Lizzie, what's up with Bea?
I think she's just a bit down in the dumps. What she really needs is a good laugh. Yeah.
You could have knocked me over with a feather when they said some smart ass had half drowned the track. You know what our stick dynasty's like in the wet.
Yeah, now if you're lucky. By the time I heard about it, it was too bloody late to get on.
Yes, it is. It's Bryce firmed in from 33s to 8. That's all I could get out of Bill.
Hey, you should have seen her get on the phone, Murray. I don't reckon I've ever seen her move so fast. I thought the pub was on fire.
Yeah. And then he'd only let me put a lousy $10 on it.
You're still $80 up, though.
Well, it's not the same, though, is it?
Look, how much did you start off with this morning?
Only 10. Hang on, I'll get that. Hang on. There you go. Thanks a million for the lend. Let's have another round. Have one for yourself, too, Luke.
Hey, listen, I'm aren't you supposed to be getting home early?
Nah, bugger it.
Well, you better ring your ma and let her know.
Oh, come off it, Murray. I'm a big girl now. She'll be right.
Ah, you going out tonight?
Yeah.
It's not my turn to cook, is it?
No, Cinderella. You may go to the ball. Actually, I'm just going to have a very quick meal because I'm going out later.
Ooh. Another heavy date?
Yes, with three other ladies. My friend Jenny's teaching me how to play bridge and I'm not very good at it. Now, what about you? Want me to cook enough for two?
Yes, if you don't mind. I won't be long. I thought I'd go over to Chris's place, see if he'd be interested in the housekeeper. I thought one of the women at Driscoll House could use the work.
Do you think that's advisable?
What does that mean?
Well, I just wouldn't get too involved, that's all.
Meg, I think you're the last one who can talk. Come on. All I'm trying to do is help Chris and possibly find some work for one of the women. Any harm in that? See you.
G'day. This is for you.
You've been drinking?
Oh, I only had a couple. I bumped into an old mate. I got your favourites.
You've precious little money as it is. You should be saving it, not throwing it away on chocolates and drink.
Oh, I got a job, haven't I? I'm allowed to spend a bit now and again.
Who was this friend of yours?
Come off it, Mum.
Was it a man?
Yeah, it was a man. But not like that. It's just an old cobber.
What was his name?
It was Maury. Do you want to make something of it?
Maury Parks? Oh, that'd be right. Tried to lead your father astray and now he's starting on you. Look, you've been out less than a week, Faye. I had hoped that this time things would be different, but you're just slipping back into your old ways, aren't you? God, you're your father's daughter, all right. Drinking, gambling, always trying to find the easy way out. Prison hasn't taught you a thing.
Garbage! Prison's taught me a hell of a lot. It's taught me to have a good time while I can because I never know when I'm going to get kicked in the teeth again. Yeah, and it's taught me that I'm as good as anyone else and not the no-hoper that you and Glynis and everybody else says I am. You know, Murray's just about the only decent mate I got left. So what if he was Dad's mate? At least he accepts me for what I am, and he's not ashamed to be seen with me like the rest of you are.
And as oh. Steve, will you get those dirty clothes off? Get under the shower, please.
I just want to twist that.
Move it, will you?
I'll get it.
The Eskimo said, it's tough.
Stephen,
who's going?
Not only are the walls made of ice, but inside,
Hello. Hi. Look, I rang Mrs. Morris this morning and she said, she said it was all
no,
right.
No, I know. It's not about the shows.
Enoch, the Eskimo.
Oh. Have I caught you at a bad time?
It's tough living
in
England.
Do you need a hand?
I got a safe check.
Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside,
please.
Even the blanks.
It's only meat pie and veggies, but you're very welcome to stay.
No, really, I couldn't.
It works.
They like it. I like you too. Come on. Why don't you stay?
Enoch the Eskimos.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare of waking up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses here are prisoners too, when morning comes around.